Hello children, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn EVS 2, Shivaji's Education, Part 2. What Veer Mata Jijabai taught Shivaji? Jijabai was no ordinary woman. She was the daughter of the mighty Sardar Lakhuji Rao Jadhav and the wife of brave and valiant Shahaji Raji. She had inherited the knowledge of politics and warfare from her infancy. In her was witnessed the confluence of the martial tradition of the famous house of the Jadhavs and Bhosles. She was a freedom-loving person with a great sense of pride. She had learned through bitter experiences that however much a Maratha Sardar displayed valor, it was not appreciated in the courts of the sultans. She had valiantly faced the shock of her father's murder in the open court at the investigation of Nizam Shah. She had resolved that her son Shivaji would never be engaged in the service of others. He would establish the rule of his own people, Swaraj. She was bringing up Shivaji with that ideal. People living in the Mawal regions were called Mawlas. They were loyal, hardworking, and quick-footed. No one could surpass them in hardiness, but they were harassed by the Sultan's rule. The armies of the Sultans used to plunder their villages, forcing the people to abandon their places. Nobody cared for them. Shivaji owned to do something for these poor, miserable people. On returning home, Shivaji would talk about this to his mother. Jijabai would say, "Shivaba, Shri Ramchandra is the ancestor of the Bhosles. Rama killed Ravan and made his people happy. The ancestors of the Jadhavas is Shri Krishna. He killed Kans and brought relief to his people. You are a descendant of both Shri Rama and Shri Krishna. You can also destroy the wicked and make your subjects happy." These words of Jijabai were a source of inspiration to young Shivaji. He would remember the brave deeds of heroes of past like Rama, Krishna, Bhima, Arjun. He thought of them all the time. Whether asleep or awake, he felt that he too must fight against injustice as they did, and like them destroy the wicked and bring happiness to his subjects. He thought that he should become courageous and brave like these heroes of old. The new regime of Shivaji. In Pune Jagir, the new regime of Shivaji began under the guidance of Jijabai. Shahaji Raja had already made preparations for this. When Shahaji Raja sent Shivaji from Bangalore to Pune, he sent some of very powerful and prestigious people with him. They were Samrat Nilkant Peshwi, Balakrishna Hamante Mujumrao Mujumdar, Mankoji Dahantode Sarnobat, Raghunath Balal Sabnis, Sonopant Dabir. These were all able and fit to administer an independent kingdom. Shahaji Raja had specially deputed them to Pune to help Shivaji govern his Jagir efficiently. With their help, Shivaji began to administer his Jagir, to attend the people's grievances. Those who inflicted injustice upon the Rayon were punished. In a way, Shahaji Raja's Jagir was undergoing a transformation. Mawals got a glimpse of the future. Swaraj. It was, as it were, the dawn of Swaraj. Shivaji's marriage. In those days, people married at a very early age. So Jijamata said, "We should now get Shivaba married." Then a search for a suitable bride for Shivaba began. Soon she found the girl she wanted. Her name was Saibai. Saibai came from the Nimbalkar family of Palthan. The marriage was celebrated with great splendor. With this, I have ended my chapter. Thanks for watching.